You know what? It's been a long time since a movie has made me feel this way. The best feeling in the world is when you walk out of the theater thinking to yourself, that was something special. And Cmon was something special. What is up, flick fans? Welcome back to my channel. Brand new A24 movie starring Joaquin Phoenix. It's in black and white, as is this video. And I just can't wait to talk about this. Why I believe this is one of the best movies of the year. Let's get into it, spoiler free. So, Johnny, played by Joaquin Phoenix, and his young nephew, played by Woody Norman, forge a tenuous but transformational relationship as they are unexpectedly thrown together in this delicate and deeply moving story about the connections between adults and children, the past and the future. Mike Mills, director of Beginners and 20th Century Women, which I thought was just a wonderful film. In this film, you have actors like Gaby Hoffmann, Scoop McNairy, Woody Norman, who is the newcomer of the bunch, and then, of course, Joaquin Phoenix. Now, going into this movie, my hype level was pretty high, but I would say around the same marks as something like a Belfast or an upcoming movie like Nightmare Alley, right? It wasn't my definitive, absolute, most anticipated movie of the year, but I thought it would be good. And as soon as the movie ended, I didn't want to get up. I sat through the credits. I sat through a little discussion that the person in charge had with the audience. We were kind of responding back and forth. People were giving their thoughts on the film. I didn't say anything. I honestly wanted to sit in silence because I knew I had just experienced a movie that spoke so specifically to me. Right, and not necessarily a film that resembles things that I have done in my past, but telling a story that allows not only our main two characters to learn and progress and think about the world around us, think about how humans interact with one another, but throughout the movie, Joaquin Phoenix's character, he's a radio journalist, so he's creating a documentary of sorts where he is interviewing the younger generation, right? Kids, I guess teens, preteens, in that range, and each question that either he or his team is asking the kids allows the child to come up with a response that is just so pure and human and real. And the beautiful thing about this movie is once I actually looked into it when the film was over, I realized that these questions and interactions with these kids, they were not scripted. And according to what I have read, they were actually told that they just had to answer some questions. They didn't know they were being in a movie. They didn't know Joaquin Phoenix was going to be one of the people asking them questions, so they were probably like, hey, why is the Joker here? What's going on? But you got some beautiful and, like I said, authentic, pure responses that make this movie. They elevate the film above even what the narrative between the two main characters was able to provide. And then you have the story itself and kind of what's happening with this young boy's mother, the fact that she needs someone to watch her child. Okay, how about my brother, who maybe I don't have the best relationship with? And that's something that is somewhat talked about throughout the film. But they get together and such distinctly different human beings, at least it seems like that at first. But the more they get out of each other, a young kid with an outlook on life that is so distinct from anyone his age, and then this older man who's been through so much and he's trying his best to contain his emotions, and he feels one way about the world and his mind is continuing to be opened up as he's getting all of these interviews. But as these two, you know, get to interact just a bit more and start to form that bond, that relationship that carries this film emotionally and just makes for one of the most incredible back and forth relationships of the entire year, the way that these two play off of each other. And again, Joaquin Phoenix, you know, he is Oscar worthy in this film, at least nomination wise, right? He's probably not going to win it over some of the other nominees, but it's not the kind of movie that will probably get many nominations because it's so distinctly artistic in that way. And we've seen movies before, something like American Animals, that combines this documentary-esque style, very different kind of movie, right, with the narrative scripted feature. But this one's handled in such a way that if it does get the right amount of push from A24, don't know if it will, probably not, then it should be considered, because I truly believe it's that good of a movie. But if you start to strip this thing down, it actually doesn't feel as directed towards the artistic crowd as maybe it does on its surface, because this is a story that everyone could get something from. Maybe you don't care as much about this young kid, or you don't care as much about that relationship, sure, But if you start to feel this emotion between the two and the banter, such great dialogue. I want to know how much of this movie was actually scripted because it feels like some of these interactions, they are so authentic. I keep using that word. It just feels like a lot of it came from the heart. And that's how you want to feel walking out of a movie like this. But one that I think the general audience is genuinely going to get a lot out of because it's such a real and human movie. And digging deep into the minds of each other, but seeing how Woody Norman's character works and goes about the world. And there's some great conversations in there. One moment where Phoenix tells him, he says, you know, you're not going to remember this interaction that we just had, a very sweet and genuine moment, but I will. I'll remember. And that's moments like that throughout this movie. It had me choking up. I felt every ounce of heart that Mike Mills put into this film. His best film, in my opinion, bar none, absolutely his best film. And then insert Gaby Hoffmann's Viv, who is dealing with so much on her side of things, not knowing how to tell Jesse, not knowing how to tell her son that, okay, here's the reason why you're having to go off with your uncle. And that in itself is a heartbreaking storyline because this child really has no clue what's going on his father's side of things. So a great story there. And at its core, it's a road trip movie. Yeah, because they're going all around the United States, and every time we enter a new location, we get maybe a 2 to 3 minute montage kind of describing the area. Here is New Orleans. Here is New York. These are what these areas are known for, and how these children, their living conditions vary all around. And then asking questions about the future to these kids, and Jesse's character having to kind of grapple with that. It's such a simplistic thing, but one that feels so natural. The way Mike Mills goes about bringing this to us, I can't tell you enough how much I love this movie. Just everything about it, every little moment, every little interaction. And then visually, which I believe is the best part, but one of the best parts of the entire film. The cinematography, for one, is just immaculate, but the actual grayscale, right? The darker blacks in the background, the lighter grays in the foreground, kind of switching up that formula. Every location that they go to, there's so much attention to detail, not only narratively, but visually in this movie, and then that mixing and mashing of somewhat of a documentary style. I mean, not really, but somewhat, and then the story itself kind of captivating you, the way that it ends, the banter, the interactions, the humor that comes from some of these lines from the character of Jesse, just hilarious. I mean, it's something, you know, your kid's going to say something, they don't know any better, cracks you up, but also dealing and trying to grapple with what's happening on his mother's side of things. So all of those things come together to create one of my absolute favorite experiences of this entire year, the most emotional film I've watched all year, and part of the reason why I connect so much is because I love that friendship, that bond that can form between two family members, and you get that here, and performance-wise, Joaquin, incredible. But really, the standout is Woody Norman. I don't know if he would ever get a nomination, but if you ask me, does he deserve one? Absolutely. Supporting actor, I would vote Woody Norman every day of the week. He's phenomenal in this film. So before I give you guys my score, what is your favorite A24 film? And if you like this video, drop your thumbs up to support what we are doing over here. So Come On, Come On is an easy contender for best of the year. The film features a beautiful look at humanity, a surprisingly refreshing road trip story, and nuanced direction. Mike Mills delivers his best work, Joaquin Phoenix is brilliantly subtle, and Woody Norman is truly spectacular. You're not ready for this. My score is a 98%. I found very little wrong with this movie, and the way that it hit me emotionally is the most impactful film I've seen all year. I thought it was phenomenal. So if I could recommend any film coming out over the next couple of weeks, it would be Come On, Come On. And I just appreciate you guys so much for your support on these videos, on these reviews, and saying, hey, Austin, drive 2 hours to watch this movie. That's what I did for you guys. So appreciate you big time for watching. Stay tuned. Like I said, we have Ghostbusters, Afterlife, King Richard, and plenty more streaming reviews. All right, guys. See you soon.